why must you learn how to reduce fractions? Well, they're easier to understand and they're easier to visualize. Let me show you. If you'd enter a store and see some eggs, how much do the eggs cost? Six halves dollars. That's strange. Which do you prefer to see? $6 or $3? $3? I'm the same way. Most people prefer to see $3 because it's easier to understand. It's easier to visualize. How do we reduce fractions? We will draw. No, we don't need to have the same skills as Pablo Picasso. We will draw simple shapes, like circles, squares, triangles, maybe stars. Simple shapes. Now, I'll show you how to reduce this fraction, 3/6. What are we going to do? Draw. This 3 becomes 3 triangles. And this 6 becomes 6 triangles. You don't have to draw triangles. If you want, you can draw circles or squares, stars. It doesn't really matter. I chose triangles. Now, what are we going to do? We are going to take the numerator and split it into different groups. And then we're going to take the denominator and split that into different groups as well. Each group must have the same number of triangles. We're going to start with the numerator because the 3 in the numerator is smaller than the 6 in the denominator, which means we're going to have to split 3 into different groups. Let's see, maybe we can try 2. We circle 2 triangles here, and we circle 1 triangle there. Well, we can't do that because remember, 2 and 1, they're not the same size group. We can't do that. Remember that each group must have the same number of triangles. Maybe try 3. Now, we're going to split the denominator into groups of 3 triangles because the numerator has been split into groups of 3 triangles. 1, 2, 3, there's one group. 1, 2, 3, there's another group. Perfect. What is our answer? One group on the top. So we have 1 in the numerator. And 1, 2 groups on the bottom. So we have 2 in the denominator, and our answer is 1/2. You see this 3 here? This group of 3? What does that mean exactly? Well, you're dividing by 3. And this group of 3 in the denominator, as well as the other group of 3, what does that mean? Well, again, it means you're dividing by 3. You get the same answer either way. Now, let's try another one. 6/8. What are we going to do? This 6 becomes 6 triangles. And And this 8 becomes 8 triangles. Remember, you must split the numerator and the denominator into different groups. Each group must have the same number of triangles. I'm going to start with the numerator. Because this 6 in the numerator is smaller than this 8 in the denominator. You see the 6 in the numerator? You can split it into 3 and 3. Now, the denominator must be split into groups of 3. Because the numerator has been split into groups of 3. Oh, can't do it. Because there's 2 left over. 2 triangles do not equal the group of 3 triangles. Can't do it. Now, in the numerator, let's try 2, because there's groups of 2 in the numerator. Now, the denominator must be divided into groups of 2 as well, because the numerator has been split into groups of 2. Perfect. What is our answer? 1, 2, 3 groups. And the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4 groups. Our answer is 3/4. You see this group of 2? And this group of 2, and this group of 2. What does all that mean? Means you're dividing by 2. And you see this group of 2 in the denominator? And this one, and this group of 2, and this group of 2. What do all those mean? Well, again, means you're dividing by 2. Answer is the same. Now, suppose you've got this fraction, 4/7. What are we going to do? Right. This 4 becomes 4 triangles. This 7 becomes 7 triangles. Remember, the numerator, the denominator must be divided into different groups. Each group must have the same number of triangles. I'm going to start with the numerator, because the numerator, that 4 there, is smaller than 7 in the denominator. Let's try 2. Now, the denominator must be split into groups of 2 as well, because the numerator has been split into groups of 2. Ah, can't do it. Because there's 1 left over. 1 triangle doesn't equal the two triangles that need to be circled. Can't do it. Maybe try three. Oh, can't do that one either, because there's one left over. One triangle doesn't equal the three that need to be circled. Can't do it. Four triangles? Now, the denominator must be split into groups of four as well, because the numerator has been split into a group of four. Ah, can't do that, because three triangles is not the same as the group of four that we circled. Can't do it. 4/7 cannot be reduced. We tried two, didn't work. We tried groups of three, didn't work. We tried groups of four and we couldn't get it to work. The only group that will work is one. See the numerator? It's got a group of one. What does that mean? It means that you're dividing by one. And if you see the denominator, that's a group of one, which means, again, you're dividing by one. This fraction is the same as what we started with. The answer is the same, 4/7.
Thank you for watching. Now watch more math videos.